Hello, Dr. Samina Mitha here, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about myo-inositol and the five most common benefits that we've seen in the research. So what is myo-inositol? Myo-inositol actually naturally occurs in our body, and it's actually known to be an isomer of a B vitamin. So it actually kind of looks like a B vitamin in terms of its chemical structure. In women with PCOS, we do find that myo-inositol, or inositol in general, is lower in the ovaries. So there is a little bit of a deficiency. So that's why the number one, I think, benefit of myo-inositol, especially in fertility cases, is egg quality. So in the research, they've said that PCOS women undergoing assisted reproductive technologies, it was found that egg and embryo quality was actually improved. What we do see in the ovary is that there is a 40-to-1 ratio of myo-inositol to dechiroinositol. So what does that mean? First of all, there's two types of inositols, myo and dechiro, and it's really just, again, the chemical structure is a little bit different between the two. We do find that we want that specific ratio because that can mimic the ratio we do see in the ovary. And we do find when using that ratio in a supplemental form, it can help with assisted reproductive technologies and also egg quality. So the second and most important thing when it comes to PCOS is oftentimes we do see insulin resistance as a cause of PCOS. And so myo-inositol has actually been extensively studied for insulin resistance and also has been compared to metformin. So I'll get into that in a little bit. But basically, they did a meta-analysis, and it was found that myo-inositol improved fasting insulin levels and also HOMA-IR. This is a calculation for insulin resistance, along with reducing testosterone levels. And a meta-analysis is when they go and they search all the studies that have quoted myo-inositol for insulin resistance, and they kind of collaborate all that information and present, the results based on everything that has been found through the research. So very, very important. And how myo-inositol works is it actually resensitizes the cells to insulin, allowing insulin to bind to the receptor sites on the cell wall to allow for glucose to come inside the cell. So really, really important, because what happens when there's insulin resistance is the insulin cannot bind, glucose cannot get into the cell, so we have more blood sugar and more blood insulin. So actually working at the cellular level is really important, and that's what myo-inositol does. It improves insulin sensitivity. The third thing that we know is that when insulin resistance is high, meaning that there's higher amounts of insulin in the bloodstream, it can actually increase testosterone. So if we work on the insulin resistance part and we bring the insulin down by working on the cells, we'll actually reduce insulin, and that will eventually lower testosterone. But even the studies have shown that myo-inositol can actually reduce testosterone. So that's the third benefit, is myo-inositol can actually lower testosterone levels in the body in PCOS women, which is so important because, high androgens are very common, can cause hair loss, excessive hair growth, hirsutism, and also acne. And the fourth thing is myo-inositol has also been studied for mood disorders. There was a meta-analysis that was done, and it concluded that inositol was beneficial for depressive patients, especially those with PMDD. So this is really, really important to look at, because we do find in PCOS women, we do have an increased risk for anxiety and depression, so myo-inositol could be helpful here as well. What they also found was that higher dosages, around 12 to 18 grams of inositol, was shown to have beneficial effects in OCD and panic disorders. So it can be really, really helpful, especially if there's anything related to mood in the case. Last but not least, myo-inositol can actually regulate cycles. It's actually responsible for the decrease in LH. This is luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone actually increases testosterone in the ovary, And it actually benefits the high LH to FSH ratio, which we commonly see in PCOS, and also can reduce testosterone and androstenedione. And androstenedione is a precursor to testosterone. So when we bring testosterone and LH down and the LH to FSH ratio, then we do find the body is able to ovulate better, because now we can actually create estrogen to allow for ovulation to occur. So really, really important benefit for myo-inositol. And so I'm just going to recap. We said egg quality, insulin resistance, it lowers testosterone. Myo-inositol helps to balance mood and also regulate cycles. So lots and lots of benefits. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about metformin and myo-inositol. Metformin is a drug that's commonly recommended for patients with PCOS who have insulin resistance or issues with blood sugar management. What it does is it actually reduces glucose uptake in the stomach area and in the digestive system. And so when we think about, you know, if we were to compare myo-inositol to metformin, in the research, there was actually a meta-analysis that was done, and it was found that both were actually equally effective at reducing fasting insulin, testosterone, and reducing BMI. However, due to the GI effects, so the gastrointestinal effects with metformin, the study actually concluded that, and quote, the better tolerability of metformin, or sorry, myo-inositol. So the better tolerability of myo-inositol actually makes it acceptable for the recovery of androgenic and the metabolic profile of PCOS women. So the side effects we most commonly see are loose stools, which can be pretty debilitating, especially if you're at work or if you're out on the go. And so myo-inositol could be a little bit better tolerated in terms of, you know, the side effect profile, and it's still its ability to reduce testosterone and also insulin and balance blood sugar. So I'm going to talk about the most common questions I get when it comes to myo-inositol. The first question I usually get is, does everyone need to take myo-inositol if you have PCOS? And the answer to that question is it really depends on the person. If insulin resistance is very predominant in the case, it can be very indicated to take myo-inositol. However, it can also benefit women who don't have full-blown insulin resistance. For example, if there's cravings or if you're feeling hangry, so if you haven't eaten in a while and you get upset and irritable, it can help with those symptoms. And also, I said cravings, but also for carbs and sugar. So if you feel like there's some blood sugar management issues, you know, and maybe there's not a lot of insulin resistance, but insulin resistance is present in a little bit, then maybe inositol would be beneficial here. The second question I usually get is, do I have to take it for life? Well, the major thing that we're trying to do is really focus on diet and lifestyle when it comes to insulin resistance. But oftentimes, when that improves, we do see a benefit to blood sugar management and insulin resistance. So maybe it doesn't need to be used long term. However, you kind of have to see what you're experiencing. If you still have issues with cravings and whatnot, it can be beneficial to keep it in. The other thing is, we are typically deficient in myo-inositol, even though it naturally occurs in our bodies. PCOS women are deficient, so it can be helpful for long periods of time. Can you take it with metformin? This is a really common question. And yes, you can actually take it with metformin. Lots of research has been done when patients take metformin and myo-inositol together, so it is safe to take together. Another question I get is there a best time to take it? And no, there really isn't. You know, taking it at any time during the day would be beneficial. I usually recommend powder form, because to get to 4 grams daily, which is the recommended dose based on what we've seen in the research, just putting it into some water and drinking it at any point during the day can be really helpful. And then how long does it actually take to work? So in terms of myo-inositol, I usually recommend waiting at least 3 months to see if it works. Because if we think about what we're trying to accomplish here, if we're trying to regulate cycles and improve egg quality, and you know, also insulin resistance, I would give the body at least 3 months. It does take the body at least 3 months for an egg to mature. So giving it at least 3 months would be your best bet. And then one thing to just note is in some women, from what I've seen clinically, it's a very, very, very small population of women. Maybe, you know, one or two people that I have seen this happen to, is that it can cause looser stools, similar to what we see in metformin, but it's very uncommon based on what I've personally seen in practice. So I hope this was helpful in teaching you a little bit about what myo-inositol is, some of its benefits, its comparison to metformin, and then also commonly asked questions. If you have any questions or comments at all, please drop them in the comments below, and I'll be sure to get back to you. Take care, everyone.